Well, good morning, YouTube. We're out in the garden shed today. This is the MT50 remote display that's on my 20 amp solar charge controller out here. And you can see we're bringing in about a tenth of an amp at 40 volts from the solar panels. I've got a pair of 12 volt lead acid batteries in parallel. They're being charged right now. And my DC load is zero right now. If I turn on a light, we jump up to 7/10 of an amp. So I've got my load hooked up off of here. So I had a viewer ask a question here. This is obviously a 12 volt system. We've got 12 volt batteries. This viewer has a similar setup. He's got a 12 volt battery, and he was concerned because if he goes down here to the device information, it says 24 volts. Am I going to burn up my 12 volt batteries because this says 24 volts? How do I change this? The short answer is this is just the nameplate data for the charge controller. It's rated for up to 24 volts. This charge controller is rated at 20 amps charging current and then also 20 amps on discharge current or the DC load. But this has nothing to do with the setting of the output. That's down here in the control parameters. So if I go down here, I've got battery type. I have a user type set in there. Then on the second screen, if you go in here and I want to change something, I can go over here. There's auto voltage detection. The default setting on these is they're set up for automatic detection. But I could hard code this for 24 volts, or I could hard code it for 12 volts. I just prefer to leave it on auto and let it pick the right voltage. Probably the only time you might do the fixed settings is if you have some weird battery setup that confuses the thing and it picks the wrong voltage. So that's control parameters tell you what voltage this is set for. The device info just tells you what the unit is capable of. So those are two different things. So let's go look at the other 12 volt charge controller that I'm running right now just to show you that that's the case. Okay, so this is the second MT50 that I have. This is hooked up to my 40 amp charge controller. And you can see we're running 12 volt battery here. This is hooked up to a 12 volt lead acid battery bank. And I've got 27 volts coming in. That's actually coming in off of my 24 volt lithium ion battery bank. So this system here is set up to power my DC loads and to keep my old 12 volt battery bank charged. And if we go in here, and if I go to device information, you can see this controller actually displays the model number. So it's the 4215BN model. Rated voltage, 24 volts. I'm running it 12 volts. Its rated charge current is 40 amps. And its rated discharge or DC load current is 20 amps. And if we get back out of there, if we go down to control parameters, I've got the auto voltage set. And it's running on a 12 volt lead acid battery, but still showing 24 volts on this screen here. And if we go up there, device info, 24 volts. So that 24 volts is just the nameplate rating of the charge controller. It has nothing to do with how it's set up, what it's configured for. That's just the maximum output that it has. So anyway, hope that clears up that question. And yeah, if you have any more questions about these MT50 displays or the charge controller's setup, feel free to post up in the comments section below. I might not know the answer, but there's a lot of really clever viewers that respond to questions as well. And as always, thanks for watching.